Top of the morning to you. It is Thursday, the West Virginia Spring Gobbler season opening week, day number 4. And it's been a nice week so far. Monday was terrible for me for the weather-wise. Seth and Joe, we get them two birds on Tuesday. Madison got one yesterday. Hunting solo this morning, so we'll see how that works out. Hopefully I can get one in and get me on the board. We're going up here to a farm, the same farm I was at on Monday. We're just going to a different location. And the reason I'm doing that is because, well, obviously I didn't see any birds where I was at Monday morning. But I've noticed 2 evenings this week that birds have been in a different field. Like at 7:25, 7:30 in the evening. So they're roosting very close to this field. 3 gobblers one night. Last night there were 2 gobblers, 3 jakes, and 7 hens. And my thought process is, if they're that close before fly up, you know, 20, 30 minutes before they're getting up on the roost, they're roosting very close to this field. There's a very, very good chance that if they're there in that field of an evening feeding, they're going to go to that field first thing in the morning. That's my thought. That's my plan. Sticking to it right now. I'm gonna go up here and drag out my blind and everything across this field and pop it up and see what happens. So this is about as good a setup as we can have. It was beautiful yesterday. You got up in the 70s. Felt like spring again, and it hasn't felt that way for 3 or 4 days. And as luck would have it, a front came through last night about midnight and rained a little bit, and we got a little bit of a breeze, which isn't going to be all that great of a thing to have. And it's 48 degrees, and it's going to stay about 45, 48 degrees all day long. So as warm as we are now is as warm as it's going to be. So get this mess out of the way. Tomorrow should feel like spring again. So I'm anxious to go up here, see what we can do. Cautiously optimistic that I should be able to wrap a tag around one's leg. Let's see here, it's 5:20. Let's say 2 hours, 7:20, 7:30-ish maybe. We'll see what happens. 6:38, we haven't heard a thing, the wind. Well, it seemed calm at the house is rocking and rolling up here. Down low, where, you know, we've got a steady breeze, the grass is moving. But up high, when you look at the trees, man, they're just rocking. I mean, just rocking. I don't know if birds are going to gobble from the roost this morning or not. If they do, it's going to be very, very difficult to hear one because of that wind going through those trees. So we'll see. Set tight here. You know, this field, this stretch of field right here where I'm at, there were 2 hens last night at 7:20, 7:25. And then off to the left of my position, there were 2 gobblers, 3 jakes, and 5 other hens. And they were feeding, you know, feeding this way. So I've got to think that they're roosting on this hillside somewhere. And whenever it gets light enough for them to want to move and fly down, I would like to think with this wind, and since they were in here feeding and pecking around last night, I'd have to think they're going to be in this field sometime early this morning.
Thank you. Holy cow. Holy cow, God. Mighty. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. I didn't know that was going to happen like that. These birds flew in, and they were going around behind me. I got 51 yards as close as they got. And then they just kind of worked around, and I started doing some more aggressive purrs, and some hens, they just act like they was leaving. And finally, these boys realized this was a Jake breeding a hen over here, and goodness, that charged right in. Had to reposition the camera. Oh my goodness. I better do the whole game over here, boys.